So who is this guy holding a bag, standing in front of a tank? This is a footage recorded by a CNN crew on 5th of June 1989 in China. They were covering the Tiananmen protests, and this video has been an iconic one, marking the resilience of an ordinary man protesting in front of a tank for his rights. So what happened? It began after the death of Hu Yaobang on 15th of April 1989. Hu Yaobang was a very popular figure in China who held the post of General Secretary of the Communist Party of China from 1982 to 1987. After the death of Mao Zedong, Deng Xiaoping rose to power and he opened up the markets of China to the outside world. It heralded a new era of economic growth for China, with massive industrialization bringing millions of people out of poverty. China posted the highest growth rate in the world for decades. Hu Yaobang was then considered to be the person who undertook this slew of economic liberalizations and political reforms under Deng Xiaoping. However, many in the party leadership were opposed to this transparency in the party and openness in the economy and society. Therefore, he was forced to resign in 1987. Hu Yaobang was a very popular leader who was seen to be pro-people, who wanted more transparency and accountability within the party and a free society. Though there was massive economic growth in that period, people were upset because of corruption, inflation, restriction in political expression, one-party monopoly, etc. Hu Yaobang's death was the turning point. It triggered the movement. Thousands of students marched on Tiananmen Square in Beijing. As it developed, more and more people from all spheres of life, like journalists, workers, and even people from the Communist Party cadres, started associating themselves with the movement as a medium to express their discontent. It was a very organic sort of movement, with no predetermined leadership or a manifesto or a fixed set of demands. It happened spontaneously and it started growing. It was not only limited to Beijing or big cities, it spread all across China. They wanted more transparency and accountability, freedom of speech and political expression, a free society, a democracy in true sense. In the initial days, the party leadership tried to negotiate with the protesters and they were asked to leave, but it failed. There was a huge gathering in the city. It even reached up to 1 million people at one time at the Tiananmen Square at the heart of the capital of China. People occupied it for around 2 months and it was some sort of a celebration of democracy in those 2 months. Ultimately, the Chinese leadership got anxious and considered the protesters as threats to their legitimacy and decided to use force to trample the protests. Martial law was declared on 20th May. Troops were mobilized. They started moving into the city but were held up by the protesters at many places. In the early morning of 4th June 1989, troops equipped with assault rifles and tanks started evacuating people from the streets. They opened fire at the protesters. Mass arrests took place all across the country and hundreds were detained and many died. Though officially China doesn't recognize any casualty figures, but unofficial accounts say from 200 to 3000 people died that day in Tiananmen Square. Many student leaders escaped to the United States, UK, and France and could never return to China. China imposed restrictions on the state media and prosecuted those who were sympathetic towards the student protesters. June 4th incident was never mentioned, neither in the print media nor in the TV media of China. Post June 4th, the Chinese state learned its lessons on how to control the press and individual freedom. And the current situation in China testified to that. It has been 30 years since the Tiananmen Square events. Around the world, rallies and protest marches have taken place yesterday in remembrance of the victims and also a call for freedom of Chinese people. More than 180,000 people participated in a candlelight vigil marking the 30 years anniversary of the Tiananmen Square in Hong Kong. But Beijing fell silent on 4th of June. Heavy security arrangements had been made and foreign journalists were blocked from entering the Tiananmen Square. There has been a deliberate attempt by the state of China to erase the memory of Tiananmen Square events from the collective conscience of the Chinese people. Chinese people made peace with economic development and compromised on their individual freedoms under the Communist Party regimes in China. But the memory of Tiananmen Square remains. And some China watchers even see an undercurrent of resentment in the people.